technology leaders' viewpoint. And ladies and gentlemen, the leader that we have on stage with us, who's going to join us, is none other than Mr. Mrityunjay Mahapatra, who's the Deputy Managing Director and CIO, SBF. He's a postgraduate in physics and business management and has varied stints in the State Bank of India, in the country and abroad for over 32 years. He's worked extensively in corporate credit, leasing, private equity, and IT functions, and is also credited with setting up a number of new businesses for the bank. May I request all of you to please give a loud round of applause as we welcome on stage Mr. Mrityunjay Mahapatra.
So in this age, we are always living like the banks themselves. What is the real information? The reality versus what is the perceived information. And we don't have time to react. Before I came, I asked my secretary, how much is my time to speak? He told, sir, 1 hour. And as all of you know, some of you who have read Kennedy, Kennedy was invited for an event to speak. And he was asked, how much notice do you want? So Kennedy told, depends on how long I'll have to speak. So the inviter told, what do you mean, how long you want to speak? He told, if I have to speak for 5 minutes, I need 1 month's notice. If I have to speak for 15, I think I need 10 days' notice. But if you want to speak me for 1 hour, I can start right now. So brevity is the soul of wit. And brevity today, small is beautiful. And what we are going to speak today is integrating banking at the core. There are three or four core design principles which I will speak to you. And these design principles are not probably any different from what the Swamiji told just now. Making your choices as to what is good for you. Always thinking that yes, what are my strengths and how do I work on my strengths to keep me energized. Remember when all of us in banking industry we joined, those days what was initially taught was that, you know, the entity concept of business. You know, as a topper in physics, when I came and joined the bank as a probationary officer, I never knew that if you have the cash, you have to debit cash account and credit from whomever you. So that entity concept of business, whether you are individually looking at things or your company is looking at things, all of us must always think that how do we leverage on the strength and gain more of it. And of course, the gratitude is that, you know, when it is converted into the language of corporate, it is about paying it back your stakeholders, whether it is employees or something. So if you want to integrate banking at the core, what we require are essentially some of the core design principles reimagined. And we'll speak about some of them. Please again, you know, some of you in this room have heard my earlier lectures, so there will be some repetition. But at the same time, as they say, good leaders tend to over-communicate their core principles. You shouldn't get tired. Maine to 10 baar bol diya hai, abhi fir ek baar bolne se kya hoga? No. one of my favorite authors, Patrick Lencioni, who has written, you know, many of the amazing books that I have ever read. He says that good leaders do not get tired of over-communicating their core design functions. So if I'm telling it once again, please take it that I consider it as important and urgent and important. So in that spirit, let us go forward. I know that, I think this, when did this conference begin? 9. So all of you are tired of the gyan overdose. So we will try to relive the journey, and in between I'll bring the experience that I have in State Bank of India, and as you know, I have good friends across the banking community all over the world, some of the things that are happening in the world. And in today's world, I firmly believe that there is no single industry which has clearly defined boundaries. As a bank, I can learn from the manufacturing industry as much as a manufacturing industry can learn from another service industry. The principles that we call the fourth industrial revolution has made these boundaries very, very fuzzy. So let us travel this journey and see what I have learned and what we are going to. Well-known themes, but key design principle. Whether you want it or not, you must be ready for this. You going and operating somewhere else, someone else coming and operating in you. The writing is clear on the wall. It is not the Olas and Ubers and Amazons and BNB has to teach us this. It is our own Indian payment system. It is all the API driven economy. Unique ID Authority of India. We have our own homegrown examples which says that whether you want it or not, the ecosystem will force it on you. So if you are literate enough to read the writing on the wall, be prepared for it. Otherwise, you will be operating in the periphery while your core is getting eroded. Because your enemies, whether it is competition, whether it is technology, whether it is industries like, let us say for banking, who are attacking us, the retail industry, telecom industry. They will not hit you in the periphery anymore. They will hit you with a disruption which will hit you on the guts so that you are neutralized in one stroke. And that is happening with these tools. You cannot say that I have the best Oracle stack and I will be prevented. Solutions is becoming technology agnostic. Whatever may be the technology of your partner who is coming to interoperate on you, or you are going to interoperate on somebody else, your technology should be able to plug in without notice, seamlessly. Make your stack ready, make your people ready, make your process ready. That is what we are doing in SBI. That is one reason why this bank has survived 212 years. Another thing is that, you know, you must be, I was in Israel last month. There is no country like that country. Surrounded by enemy, looked down by enemy waiting to kill them. But innovatively, thinking with all the paranoia that is there in the world about security. And of course, you will have to, you know, deliver continuous experience. As I told, I came here thinking that I have 1 hour, but I have to finish in 25 minutes or 30 minutes. Security, you know, gone are the days when, you know, you have all the luxury of waiting for a thing to happen and it is nibbling, it will hit you in the gut, as I told you. Straight away in the gut to neutralize it. How do you face it? What is your adaptive security? Experience will rule. I am spending maximum amount of time on WhatsApp. I would like to do everything on WhatsApp. Whether I want a very simple, plain, vanilla, down-to-earth experience, or I want a complex, menu-driven, five steps, security-full experience is my choice. Your IT stack has to provide it. And you have to build it when you are doing enterprise architecture, when you are doing architecture of your IT stack. Please remember, going forward, I do not know whether it will come here or not, architecture will rule. Please invest money in architecture. It may sound like a high sounding word, but in one place, all your design principles must coalesce, must talk to each other, must give a uniform impression. Else, you will be compromising on getting the mind space. Is no more, it is about the wallet share or anything like that. Wallet share will be directly proportional to the mind share that you have of the customer. And mind share will be a very hazy kind of a definition. There will be no right definition of what is the mind space of the customer. You will have no beaten track to go by. You will have to define it yourself. And for this, you know, all these things you must have heard, individualization to personalization, so on and so forth. But the key theme, key design theme, is that the race for the mind space will be the battlefield of the future. How you do it? Architecture. Spend money on architecture. Recruit architects. Ask them to convert your ideas into architecture. Keep it posted on your wall. Work on it. Morning, look at it and tell how much you have achieved. The real world. And I do it every day, mind you. There is no 2 days, no two consecutive days where I have not met my enterprise architect. Because business has to be redesigned. And business has what ideas? They have vague ideas that we want to achieve it. It is for us to make the rubber hit the road. So we need architecture. What we are looking is, you know, I don't want to spend time, but you know, last one I'll say that interest and fee income, I have told this many a times, will cease to be the drivers of profit of banks. It is monetization of data and monetization of insights which will rule. How we take forward. Again, no beaten tracks. You are your own guide. If you want to waste money on consultants, you should be happy to do it. But it will have to come from your own company. But the design principle is clear. If you want to design, redesign your core, redesign your insights. Data is called as new oil, but data is the crude oil. You will have to have the refinery of data and analytics to get a useful product. So, business models are getting disrupted. Core will change along with. This is a derivative of what I told in the beginning. If you remember, what I told was that platformization will rule. What is platformization? You don't have to build a, you know, of course I am doing it because there are I believe that for next 8 or 10 years, I have to live with hybrid. So I'm building my own data center and all those things. But having a 500 rack data center or 1000 rack data center, or having, you know, having a beautifully looking website, or it doesn't matter if you have an asset in the cloud, or, you know, as one of my close mentors, Dr. Sekran or Patterson, says, going forward, you will not, you know, compare between a Canon camera and a Nikon camera. You'll buy the box. If you're going for a marriage, you'll download the portrait photography software, pay per use, forget about it. If you're going on a trail, buy the nature photography software from the cloud, use it in that box, forget about it. So assets will be replaced by access. Is your core ready for that? Again, examination is not difficult. It all requires the old-fashioned notebook and pencil. And calling your core group members, asking a few questions. I do it every day almost, every week at least. Because the answer is with us. We don't have to go outside to look for it. Now, some of it, you know, cloud native applications and architecture, budget and cost control, for example, in SBI we are doing. Everything is ROI required, chargeback model, these are all the fashions. How do I access this? Now, build versus buy used to be the traditional way of managing enterprises. Lease versus buy. Now, these will be replaced by access. How long I need it? SBI, for example, I'll tell you one example. You know IRCTC Tatkal. Morning hours when Tatkal opens, because we are the primary provider, there is a concurrency of 50,000. And after that, it dwindles to roughly around 1,500 or so. Do I provide 50,000? Headroom, or do I have access to 50,000 concurrency? How do I redesign it? That is going to be your core redesigning concept. So think about it. Again, as I told, operational efficiencies will rule. How we can save money, because boards, for example, will gradually, there was a phase from, let us say, 4 years before to probably 1 year from now, where boards will blindly approve whatever the CIO or the CTO is taking to the board, because they are scared that if we don't provide for IT, then we will be less competitive. But gradually, boards will realize that probably money is getting wasted. Money is not wasted, but money is not being efficiently put to use. So in those areas, as a community of CXOs, we must determine that what is the efficiency quotient of our investment. Security, I told. How do we do security? Now, investments have to go to security in a futuristic manner. Security is one area where you will have to convince your seniors, or your, you know, if you yourself is the fellow with whom the buck stops. Rest assured that security right now will not be able to prove the ROI. But we will have to invest. Invest in training, invest in many other things, not just security. You know, identify, as they say, the security cycle is, you know, identify, protect, these are proactive part of it, detect, prevent, and, you know, sanitize. All the 5-6 steps of security has to go hand in hand, and there is they will come in no particular order, mind you. In all the 5 fronts, you will have to invest. SBI has the, you know, biggest security operations center, ISO certified. We kill roughly 80% of the IPs that hit our firewall. It's a difficult, complex task. Talent is not easily available in the market. You will have to build your talent. But trust me, one thing, you know, I told in another conference that please rest assured, the young kids that are coming, if you can invest 20, please do not go, you know, again, my own personal experience, I have hit success again and again and again. Biggest aspirational value, train them, they will pick up like anything. Boys and girls who are coming from tier 2, tier 3 cities, gold mine of talents. Just they require, and the 10 years experience that you are talking of taking a market professional, you can put them into these young kids in a better fashion in 2.5 years time. 1/4 of the time that these people have taken to acquire. Invest in them. Very, very successful I have been, and I am grateful that I have tried with them. This is one, you know, when we did a study, we found that, you know, roughly 25% of the fintechs are engaged in this space. This looks very cool. Another 18-19% of the fintechs are engaged in analytics. About 10-12% in security and fraud management, risk management. But this is the maximum kind of attraction. There are a number of emerging technologies, but many of those, you know, will be experimented over a period of time. Blockchain, for example. I wrote a few articles on blockchain, Business Standard at all, and it got good readership. Also, I wrote in Economic Times. Blockchain, if you want to gain real benefit out of it, you must put it to multiple use. You cannot rest assured by putting it only to payment or to a trade finance or something. Assets must be put to multiple use to get the ROI in the short term, because I call my innovation department as innovation and quick win. Quick wins must be one thing which must be always on the top of your radar, because we are commercial organizations. We are not R&D or academia, where whatever goes in, nobody will question. The boards may support you for 1 year or something. They will ask questions. So you will have to establish those quick wins. And those quick wins must be part of the design document. So in payments, blockchain quick wins you can do. And another thing that I'm seeing is that, you know, already we are implementing in SBI, you know, tokenization and virtual card. I see a clear writing on the wall. Even if the POS machines, as you know, SBI has the largest POS machine network, 6.5 lakh, and we are planning to do it. What we are seeing clearly is that even the POS machines will work with virtual cards on your mobile or any other device. So there we will have to, you know, kind of deal with that. I told about this. Except for regulatory barriers, banking is a commodity business. Differentiations will be increasingly reverse engineered. It is already being reverse engineered. What is differentiation? How long it will last? With open source, it will not be also expensive. So, what will happen is that you should learn from best practices. How a manufacturing sector is trying to re-engineer its assembly line. Probably your delivery line has to take lessons from the manufacturing sector. So this convergence of knowledge, convergence of ideas, convergence of best practices, you should be ready, your organization should be ready, the core of your organization, the culture of your organization should be ready to embrace it and take it forward. Some of the things we forget, I have written here, because if you want to transform it, one is that, you know, we do not invest enough money in our talent acquisition. Your core business always consumes a lot of your technology spend. How do I increase my top line? How do I acquire more customers? Are we investing in cutting edge technology for talent acquisition and employee lifecycle management? Please ask this question. How much money we have invested in that? How much talent we have put to that? Because as the book which I read some years back, employees first, customers second. If you take care of your employees first, a lot of the problems will be raised. Now, open source, no support. But fortunately, you will have to bring in your community or collaborate with like-minded players to build those communities. A gold mine is waiting. Personally, you know, I have created an open source center of excellence in SBI, and majority of the solutions that I am getting is at one-tenth of the cost. One-tenth, mind you. Tell your vendors, all of them are masters at taking open source, curating it, and selling it as proprietary software. Find that game. Play that game and be ready to harness the benefits, because otherwise the core will not change. You will be vendor dependent, at the end of it, you will come to grief. Another thing is that, you know, IoT, very well to say in these kind of conferences that yes, IoT, IoT, IoT. IoT requires design level changes for sensors and artifacts at the endpoint. What is your design document? That's why I do not forget or do not get tired of telling architecture, architecture, architecture. If you are buying a new turnstile, are you asking the fellow that do you have sensors in that which will relate to my control center? I can find, I can do analytics on that. When you are buying a new server, what about the maintenance? Are you asking, does it have the IoT sensor? Otherwise, what will happen is that it is like the old village family home where you build a two-room house and on the side you build another when your parents get old. When you get a servant, you get another. For parking your vehicle, you build a garage, and at the end of it, there is no architecture. It is a mismatched riffraff. Microservices, of course, I am sure all of you, SBI, I have created a completely new vertical for, you know, enterprise education there. Core bankings will get tired. Core bankings have to be only ledger. Everything will get worked through the middle layer and the service layer. Platformization, if that is the architecture, the core architectural principle is microservices. How you can miniaturize your service. Because otherwise what will happen is that APIs will also become bulky. Your partners will not be able to consume it. Invest in APIs. These are something, you know, futuristic. All of you have spoken, so I'll not tell about it. But only thing is that invest in AI, ML, artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning. These are big terms. But essentially, these are higher forms of analytics. Don't get flustered by industry jargon. Read something, even I think a Google search is enough to give you enough knowledge. You know, when we were reading for civil service and banking examination, many times we were told to read the NCERT books meant for 9th and 10th class, geography and no higher. If you get your basics right, I think you have the experience and training to take it forward. All enablers, I told incubators. We have just yesterday I launched another open hackathon, which is called, you know, Digitize for Bank. So all the accelerator, the tools for, you know, doing agile thing, again, I always tell, agile as is practiced in ING Bank or as one of your vendors will tell is not the right way. Agile as has been designed in the West is meant for the Western people who cannot focus on more than one or two things. So they want collaboration because five things has to be done. Somebody is coding, somebody is deploying, somebody is system integrating, somebody is scaling, somebody is... So all these people come together. But as Indians, we do eight things together, no problems. Do those cultural adjustments. Whatever is your concept, factor in your strengths. I told right at the beginning, factor in our culture. Make a model, challenge the vendors, ask them to come up with a new solution. They cannot bring a box and tell that you take this box or you don't get anything. No way, you are paying the money. You will get it, I am getting it. And as I told, ask them collaborative. And you know, transmission quotient is one thing which I tell inside the bank. Bank is spending a lot of money in SBI. I say how much is visible in the front line, that is the transmission process. Otherwise in the board level, oh, Mahapatra is a great CIO, we have never seen one of them. Doesn't mean anything to me. I'll get any of those ecolabs anytime. But how much of these technology powerhouse is getting transmitted to the front line? People who are sitting in a rural, remote branch, are they able to consume those analytic results? Are they able to do the robotic process automation? I think that will be the test which will differentiate men from boys. Please think about it, that transmission question. What we have taken, I have told, so I'll not. One thing that is coming up is in SBI, the Collaborative Innovation Center, where we have immersive experience zones, where we have collaboration zones, where we have creation zones. Is the first and probably only, you know, collaborative innovation center in a bank in India. We are spending a lot of money to give absolutely global, best-in-class kind of an experience, and this is coming shortly. And probably you will have to think your own version. It's not necessary that you will have to burn a lot of money. As we call in business, you know, fit for purpose is an important test. What you are doing. Don't get dazzled by whoever else is doing what. It may be fit for purpose for SBI, it may not be. Find out your... We have already operational in this. We are taking real world customers, asking them to test out our products and incorporate that into our, what we call it, user experience level. We have a customer journey mapping. This will be launched very soon at Yono. You need only one, you only need one. Where we are telling everything is a journey. Home loan is a journey. And it is not simply how much loan I get at 40 days. There's to go much beyond that. When I'm deciding on a house, can I go to my start home and look for the localities in Sushi? Can I find out readers is green? Can I find out, you know, which are the other schools that are available in the area? Can I find out who are the movers and factors? This is all the homegrown journey. So reimagination of this, we have identified 300-odd customer journeys and we are working. So that is what I wanted to tell you, that core needs change. And core needs change doesn't mean that you'll have to, you know, completely take everything or nothing. Take those baby steps, and I think you'll be successful. Thank you. Any questions? Yes, sir.
Mike.
I know you. Mike is not working. I can lend you mine.
So I have a very different question because you have laid a lot of emphasis and stress on architecture. And one thing that comes to my mind of this statement is merging all the subsidiaries with the parent company. And you know, all the banks should have separate architecture in terms of information. So So once you merge all these subsidiaries, so there will be one architecture for the entire merged entity of the animal platform. The principles would be one.
No, I'll tell you what the we have already merged it. I mean, just to clarify, our merger is over. We had six banks to merge, five of our associate banks, almost on the same platform and same IT architecture, except in peripherals there were difference in architecture because they were local banks, so there were a large number of local products and local cultures which have come, local rules which have been. And we had Bharatiya Mahila Bank, which was on a completely different idea. Now, how we did it was that, you know, the architecture must be driven by project management. The principles of project management, one thing I have not mentioned here is that one thing I determined when I was given this job in SBI, you know, always the head of IT comes from business. So I was heading international before coming here. So one thing I determined is that discipline and governance in large organizations is very important. So architectural differences can be tackled by IT. But what about the difference in terms of this product mapping, culture mapping? So when you are doing the architecture, how long will be the complete integration? You will have to communicate with business all the time that this is the possibility with IT. And IT architecture, as I told, is different from enterprise architecture. IT architecture looks only at designing the IT stack, the load balancers, the groups engine, the computing engine, the cloud engine, etc. Whereas enterprise architecture looks at people, process, and technology. What I was telling that invest in architecture to transform your core is to invest in enterprise architecture, where you take business along, define agile stage, and go to stage. And find a roadmap for going. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.